opportunities, from hiking up the slopes of Glacier Cap Mountains to Russia. The world's largest country offers a diverse range of travel, strolling down the shoreline of the world's oldest lake. Historical sites and cultural activities abound in the country's major cities. Whether you're walking across the steppes of Mongolia or visiting the grounds of Moscow's Kremlin, a trip to Russia is an adventure you won't soon forget. These top tourist sites in Russia might help you plan an unforgettable vacation to Russia. 10. Altay. From Russia to China, Kazakhstan, and Mongolia, the Altay Mountains run through Siberia. It is a popular tourist site for both locals and visitors. It was traditionally populated by many ethnic groups active in horse husbandry and forestry. The Altay Mountains are part of the UNESCO World Heritage Site that includes a variety of nature reserves and lakes. Altay has a lot of unspoiled beauty, with frozen rivers and snow-capped mountains attracting cross-country skiers and other outdoor enthusiasts in the winter, as well as hikers, cakers, and climbers in the summer. Diverse activities such as cave exploration, herb and mushroom gathering, and diving are also available. The bone fragments, artifacts, and even archaic horses found at the Denisova Cave in Siberia are extremely remarkable, with some dating back 50,000 years. Many tourism firms provide planned trips from the resort town of Bolokurika, which is a popular starting place for Altay adventures. 9. The Russian tundra. The tundra is a one-of-a-kind ecosystem found exclusively around or near the Arctic Circle. Only moss, bushes, and some species of grasses can survive the winter here, since the temperatures are too cold for trees to thrive. The tundra is usually associated with permafrost, which means the ground is permanently frozen. Marshes and streams from across the terrain regions, where the top layer of ground melts throughout the summer, resulting in stunning spots of multicolored icy water. During the breeding season, the Russian tundra is home to polar bears, seals, gray wolves, and a diverse range of birds. Ecotourism has grown in popularity in tundra areas in recent decades, particularly the Great Arctic State Nature Reserve near Krasnoyarsk Krai, where tourists can explore a variety of environmental paths, go bird watching, or visit as part of an educational tour. Murmansk, located on the Kola Peninsula, not only has breathtaking tundra vistas, but it's also a terrific site to go on a northern lights trip. 8. Peterhof. The Peterhof Palace is the city's claim to fame. Even though it is home to a university and a large Russian watch manufacturing, the palace grounds comprise almost 4,000 hectares and were conceived and erected in the early 1700s for Tsar Peter the Great in a style that mimics the Palace of Versailles. Around the palace, there are 173 garden fountains, some of which, like the Grand Cascade Fountains, have special characteristics that activate water jets when visitors approach them. Marble statues shaded walking lanes, and even an aviary pavilion can be found in the lower gardens, which are created in a French formal style. The Grand Palace is a work of art in and of itself, with majestic colors, gold details abound, art imported from Asia and the Far East, authentic Chinese silk walls, and a large ballroom adorned with gilded carvings. The palace houses 10 museums, each of which houses art, furniture, and palace artifacts from the 18th century. 7. Olkhan Island. Olkhan is one of the world's largest lake islands, with high mountains, rich forests, and taiga covering it. The island is located in eastern Siberia and has a small permanent population made up primarily of local Buryats, a Mongolic indigenous people who see the island as a strong spiritual site. Visitors come to explore locations like the coastal sand dunes and the abandoned Pestuneya village and old Soviet labor camp nearby, and tourism has become a growing sector on Olkhan Island. 6. Vladivostok. Strong gusts expose tree roots on the shore, giving them the impression of a standing human. On the island, there are many semi-urban villages, the largest of which is Kuzer, which offers homestays for overnight tourists. The settlement also houses the Rivyakin National History Museum, a modest but informative museum that traces life on the island from back to Neolithic times. Vladivostok's Rusky Bridge is a stunning architectural marvel and the longest cable-stayed bridge in the world at 1,885 meters. The bridge connects Vladivostok to Rusky Island, where visitors will find Filipovsky Bay and its beautiful sandy beaches, as well as Voroshilov Battery, a military museum. History buffs will appreciate a chance to explore the WW2C-56 submarine or visit the Museum Vladivostok Fortress, originally built to protect the city against potential attacks from Japan. 5. Anapa. And Napa is well-renowned for its sandy beaches, spas, and breathtaking views from the rocky peninsula where Napa's lighthouse rests, which is perfectly positioned against the Black Sea and has been a favorite resort destination for decades. Apart from seaside features, Anapa is a more modest resort than Sachai, with lots of other things to keep visitors interested. The Anapa Archaeological Museum and the only intact gate of an Ottoman fort that previously occupied this area are also worth visiting. Both the Suco Valley and the Balcho-Utrecht Wildlife Preserve are just minutes from the city and offer lots of opportunities to explore nature, swim in clean waters, and hike along the trails. 4. Novosibirsk. Novosibirsk, Russia's third largest city and the unofficial capital of Siberia, is situated on the banks of the Ob River, where summers are warm enough for swimming and sunbathing in winters, reach minus 40 degrees Celsius. The city of Novosibirsk is home to the Novosibirsk Opera and Ballet Theater, as well as several universities and museums, many diesel and steam locomotives, electric trains, snow plows, and a variety of odd carriages, such as tank cars, hospital and jail vehicles, and even fire engines, are on display at the Outdoor Museum for Railway Technology. The Trans-Siberian Railway Station in Novosibirsk is one of the country's largest, and it was previously at the heart of the transfer of inmates to Gulag's Soviet forced labor camps. It is now the primary departure point for train excursions to adjacent cities, notably Birds, which is located on the beaches of the Ob Sea, which is actually a man-made reservoir rather than a sea. 3. Sachai. Sachai is a seaside town on the Black Sea at the foot of the Caucasus Mountains, known as the Beach Resort. Sachai has traditionally been a favorite vacation resort for Russians, even though it only became glamorous after hosting the 2014 Olympics. Summers are ideal for swimming in the water, while winters are ideal for adventurous sports such as skiing, Stalin's Dacha, Vacation Residence, Mount Akon, Voronsovka Caves, Rosyv Kuderski Resort, Olympic Park, and Riviera Dolphinarium are some of the most popular attractions in Sachai. 2. St. Petersburg. This list should include one of the most popular and excellent locations to visit in Russia. St. Petersburg, like Red Square, is unquestionably a work of art in terms of architecture. This city is adorned with large parks, gorgeous cathedrals, museums, monuments, and palaces. Hotels, restaurants, taverns, and exotic dance bars are all popular in the area. 1. Moscow. Because most international planes arrive in Moscow, or at least stop there, you should arrange your vacation so that you have at least a few hours to tour the city. Russia's capital is a beautiful combination of lush nature, spectacular architecture, and numerous historical relics from a bygone era. Visitors to Moscow typically begin their explorations in the city center, which includes the Kremlin, Red Square, and the magnificent St. Basil's Cathedral. The retail mall GUM, with its glass and steel roof, is also a popular destination, even among foreigners who cannot afford the high-end goods on offer, and a fantastic spot to enjoy real Russian cuisine. Even if museums aren't your thing, Moscow has some fantastic options, such as the State Tretiakov Gallery, which only exhibits Russian art, the Pushkin Museum, which has more international collections, and the Kremlin Armory Museum, which has items like Ivan the Terrible's ivory throne and gold-covered imperial carriages. If tickets are available, the Bolshoi Theater, one of the world's largest ballet and opera houses, is also worth seeing. Considerable of Moscow's biggest attractions, such as the pedestrian-only shopping district Starый Arbat and the boardwalk along the River Moskva, need some walking to fully appreciate. Moscow's metro stations are works of art in and of themselves, with porcelain sculptures, crystal chandeliers, and one-of-a-kind mosaic artworks that transform these underground palaces into mini-palaces. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and see the rest of our videos. See you soon!